Last week, while presenting the Select Committee report on the state of affairs in NSSF, Mwine Mpaka, the chairperson of the Select Committee, said they had found out that the workers' groups Nuto and Koftu had illegally received 800 million shillings from NSSF. The committee went ahead and passed recommendations. Among them was to instruct the implicated workers' bodies to refund these funds or face prosecution.
Maybe for me, you ask about the private sector.
The workers' leaders under the umbrella body of the Central Organization of Free Trade Unions Uganda, Koftu, have said that it's true this money was received by some of their members, but they will not return it. They went ahead and punched holes in the whole report findings by Parliament, explaining that the money they have been receiving from NSSF was never misused, but rather used for financial literacy of the workers.
Understanding that should stop. And yet the money, its object is very clear. Not for us to eat, but about to increase the membership.
As government and employers. So this money is supposed to come to the tripartite. The employers, sensitize those who don't have NSSF, sensitize their workers to be part of the union, the NSSF. And then the workers also, as unions, to make sure that all the workplaces, all the workers,
The recommendations by Parliament also called for the cancellation of Memorandum of Understanding between NSSF and the workers' bodies, including resignation of the Gender Minister, Betty Amongi, and the disbursement of the NSSF board, among others. John Okecho, the chairman, general of Koftu, said that there is a mafia hand which wants to disorganize the workers. He wondered why they were not given ample time to explain to the parliamentary committee about the NSSF saga, but instead harassed them.
There should be a better method of following up the matter when it comes. We should not allow mafias to take over investigations.
Yes.
We should work as tripartite to find out where the loopholes. If the President Museveni has directed investigations, why can't you come to the workers and find out? Why are you refusing to listen even to the workers who have the data over their money? And even when the center goes to Parliament to explain, you don't listen, you only harass them. When we reached there on that day, they call police to make the people fear even to fail to talk. And there were no questions. They were only asking about nominations, whereby we clarify, but they did not even capture our letter.
Problem of NSSF, you know, brother, your much brought an issue of compliance. In fact, this man, this Muhammad of Matua Job, was even mentioning it. He was saying, how can you fail to comply? Most of the employers are deducting money from the employees, and this money is not remitted to NSSF. So that's the problem of compliance. And when your Moch brought that issue up, they started harassing him. They even wrote letters to the minister that he should be recalled, that he should not be appointed on the board. So if you're harassing your Moch, you're harassing workers. So for us as affiliated workers of Koftu, we cannot accept. We shall say our representation is genuine. We are representing the rightful people.
Last week, while appearing before the Parliament Select Committee probing the operations of NSSF, Dr. Sam Liomochi, one of the workers representing the Central Organization of Free Trade Unions Uganda on the NSSF board, was turned away over allegations of bias. NSSF investigations follows corruption allegations at the fund stemming from a letter to the NSSF board by the Minister of Gender, Betty Amongi, questioning the reappointment of the former managing director, Biarugaba, when his contract had expired. Report compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news.